Tension continues to rise around Joker. We're continuing to see a divide already among the critics and the fans, right? We're starting to already see the divide where the critics are not happy about this movie. It has their little fifis hurt. The critics are all sucking their thumbs in the corner, lamenting about this movie. And, you know, all the problems with this movie, the toxic masculinity, the MAGA messages, I don't know. It's ridiculous, man. But Joaquin Phoenix was in an interview recently with The Telegraph, okay? And somebody asked him this question. During an interview with The Telegraph, Phoenix was asked if he shared the concern that Joker might perversely end up inspiring exactly the kind of people it's about with potentially tragic results. I'm not joking you, man. Taken aback by the question, Phoenix walked out of the interview, rightfully so, though he ultimately returned after the issue was reconciled with Warner Brothers' PR department. Now, what kind of a dumbass interviewer do you have to be to ask this kind of question? Seriously, that person should be fired. I'm sorry. If you're asking these kinds of horrific questions to an actor who's doing his job in a very good way, you got problems, man. You got problems, or woman, or whoever you are. Whoever you are that interviewed him. This was a bad play on your part, man. I don't blame him for walking out. I really don't. And we're already continuing to see this where people are making this movie hyper political, hyper, and I guess just kind of obsessed with that already. I mean, of course it is the critics, so it's kind of what we've come to expect at this point. They're already kind of going after Rambo, The Last Blood, in so many ways. They're tearing that movie down already, and now it seems like they're kind of going after Joker more and more. I don't blame Phoenix for walking out, because these are not the types of questions you should be asking the actor who's trying to have a good time on his tour, I'm sure, on his press tour, promoting his movie. What, I mean, how is a question like this helpful at all? The funny thing is, I remember something kind of similar like this happening a long time ago. Not a long time ago, it was for Age of Ultron, I believe. Some interviewer asked Robert Downey Jr., during an interview for Age of Ultron, some really, really just stupid, messed up question, like, about his past life, about the drugs that he was in, or something like that. It was just a really, really bad question. It was so poorly asked and just poorly delivered, and Robert Downey Jr. ended up walking out of that interview as well. And once again, I don't blame him, okay? These are not the types of questions that people should be asking these people when they're interviewing them. They should be asking them questions about the movie, right? And about them as actors. They shouldn't be asking them these kinds of questions. This is just ridiculous, man. This is just ridiculous. I don't know what this interviewer was thinking, but man, he must have been on some really good crack or something, because this is ridiculous. This is absolutely ridiculous. There really isn't anything else in this article. I just kind of wanted to talk about that a little bit, because I was just kind of blown away by that. I don't know what they were thinking asking that kind of question. I'm excited for Joker. I am continuing to be even more excited for Joker as we're seeing more of these sensitive Sallys being offended by the movie and, you know, going in their corners and sucking their thumb and crying about this movie and just how intense it is or whatever. Like, they can't handle this movie. They just can't. Same thing with Rambo, man. People just can't handle Rambo. So many people are complaining about the violence of Rambo Last Blood. We have Grace Randolph out here who's complaining about the violence in a Rambo movie. What are you doing? man. I'm losing more and more respect for critics every day. Really, the only critic, professional critic, I guess you could say, that I have actual respect for is Jeremy Johns. Seriously, he is like the only one. Besides that, I get my opinions from other YouTubers that I know, filmmakers, you know, I guess not filmmakers, friends, things like that. So anyway, let me know in the comments below what you think about this. Do you think that Joaquin Phoenix was in the right for walking out of this interview after being asked this terrible question? Let me know in the comments below what you think. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will talk to you all very soon in another video. Talk to you later. Bye. We'll be right back.